Guy who wants the birds flying and stuff, and wants the clouds, and that's where it got started for me, and I knew I always wanted to fly.
Okay, as Ron comes out, the airplane tumbles end over end, he picks up something he recognizes, flies it out of that position, takes it back across the box, rolling back and forth, one way, left, right, back again, over 400 degrees per second roll rate in the ratchet roll. Pulls back, rolls the airplane over, pushes outside, negative G's. Negative G's are forcing Ron out of the cockpit.
Ron Cox and his buddy Steve Stavrakakis are breaking into show business with a one-of-a-kind creation, the Green Machine, the world's highest-powered small biplane. Only 16 feet long, but with a massive 350-horsepower engine pushing it to speeds over 300 miles an hour. This sucker performs. The Green Machine was born in Ron's cabinet shop in the gold country of Northern California. Steve and Ron figured that with Ron flying and Steve announcing, they could thrill aviation audiences. But to get bookings, they needed a real showstopper.
Steve had a rare airplane, and he was able to start book air shows, and I was having a hard time getting them, so I had a plane similar to what everybody else had. And then I figured, well, I'm going to build something that nobody's got. We're going to take this further than anybody's ever taken it. And do something quite different.
The Green Machine, it took shape with the help of his wife, friends, and the phone company. He called friends across the country for advice. 13 months later, it all paid off on the airstrip. What's it like to blast around the Blue Yonder in this green bullet? Well, Ron is the only one who will ever know. Not even his announcer gets to go for a ride.
No, there's no way I could fit in that airplane. The airplane was built much like an Indianapolis car. It was built around Ron's body. So unless you've got the same weight and height as him, you won't fit in that airplane. And even if you did, you'd be crazy to try and fly it.
With no small amount of tape and our fingers crossed, we strapped two tiny cameras to the Green Machine for a pilot's point of view of the wildest ride in aviation. Ron gets a real workout putting the plane through its paces. There are maneuvers he does with the Green Machine that no one else can perform. A double Lomshavak, that's Czechoslovakian for headache. It's a tumbling fall that could tear the prop from the plane and your head off your shoulders. And because the little biplane has more thrust than weight, it can hang by its prop like a helicopter.
Just hang, and it'll let it turn and turn and turn, and just in death land when I get kind of scared or tired or something, I'll pull out and go into my next maneuver.
Having the right stuff isn't all barrel rolls, high G's, and inverted spins. For Steve Stavrakakis and Ron Cox, it's following their ambitions and chasing the American dream at 300 miles an hour.
Not too long ago, while he was doing flips and cartwheels in the air, Ron's plane caught on fire and crash-landed. He broke nearly every bone in his body from his waist to his neck. Now, fortunately, he recovered, and he's rebuilt the Green Machine, and he says that it's flying better than ever. Now, I'm going to try to fly for the first time, or at least my first solo training flight of a hang glider. So, guys, are you ready for this? All right. Meantime, I'm Doug McConnell. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time right here on The Adventurers. Woo! All right!
Next on the Discovery Channel, a paraplegic mother saves her drowning toddler on Heart of Courage. Then, Antarctic ice, desert ruins, and the ocean floor yield clues to changes in the Earth's climate on Planet Earth.